Hello, I'm Catherine Patterson. The 68 dogs and puppies removed from a Bloomington residence on March 17th are on the road to recovery. Several puppies are now in foster homes.
Everyone is doing well, but we still need public support. And one thing that we really want people to consider is, are you adopting from a reputable breeder? Because this is not the first time we've seen something like this.
The shelter is also asking for monetary donations to cover health issues for several of the dogs. Bloomington police are continuing the investigation and have not yet determined if criminal charges should be filed. Duke Energy is hoping to get an Indiana Supreme Court case overturned in light of a new state law. Last year, the state Supreme Court ruled that Duke couldn't recover more than $200 million from its customers in extra costs that came with complying with federal coal ash rules. The new law aims to undo the effect of that ruling by letting utilities recover these kinds of costs without pre-approval. The bill's sponsor says that its intent wasn't to bail out Duke Energy, but to provide clarity for similar cases pending before the IURC. A bill to study how best to recycle old solar panels and wind turbines passed unanimously out of the State House today. The bill would direct the State Department of Environmental Management to work with the Utility Regulatory Commission to study the issue and a potential state program to manage it. The bill now goes back to the State Senate to consider changes made to it. And for tonight's weather, it's going to be mostly cloudy with a low of 33. And a quick look into the five-day forecast, it's going to brighten up a little later in the week, but then expect rain on Friday and Saturday. For more local news, go to WTIUnews.org and catch Indiana News Desk Fridays at 6.